Do you know the L over D rule? Sure, you would say, I'm working since ages in pharmaceutical engineering. The question itself is irritating to me. But are you aware about the details and the boundary conditions? I will shed some light into the darkness and take you with me. In one of our last videos, we were talking about branches in general. Today, I would like to follow more an academic path considering that issue. Talking about the L over D rule. And L over D means actually the length of a branch in comparison to the diameter of the branch. That's very simple. This principle has first been mentioned in an FDA draft in 1972, where this is being considered as a guidance for dead room free or hygienic design. However, since then, it's been mentioned in numerous other regulations, like World Health Organization papers, like the ISPE papers, like ASME BPE as well. So, and there are always different numbers being given. So some papers talk about 60, some about 2, some about 3, even 1.5. So how is that possible that such deviations are being mentioned in official regulations and paperwork? So the answer is actually pretty simple. People take different boundary conditions. So some measure really from the edge of the main tubing here, some measure from the center of the main tubing. So that's something that you always have to know while talking about these values. And the latest ASME BPE release, it's been given 2D, measured from the edge of the main tube here. And that's, I would say, nowadays, the standard. However, if you were considering you're adding a valve on top here, that would certainly then need to be measured to the closing edge, really, of the valve, as you see in the graphics. But how about now standard parts, such as that one here? So here we're considering a 1-inch standard equal T-piece, and if you measure the L over D in this case and consider you are closing it, you probably have this version with a clamp and you're putting a blank on top, then this T-piece is even out of spec. So if you have that in your system and you're closing it, it's considered a dead leg. Yeah, as the value L over D is here 2.5 and not below or equal to. If you're getting smaller with a diameter such as that one here, and you're considering a 3/8 of an inch branched T-piece, in this case, the value L over D would be roughly 7. So totally out of spec. So everything which is bigger than 1 inch should be okay, but everything smaller and 1 inch itself should be not okay. However, if you're looking towards shorter T-pieces or T-pieces like this one with a clamp on top, you can consider this being pretty hygienic when you put a blank on top. This is a 1-inch T-piece in this case, but let's say coming to the edge at roughly 1/2 inch and everything below 1/2 inch is also out of spec. Yeah, so that's what we need to consider while talking about dead room free conditions in standard T-pieces. That's what I wanted to say, and I hope I could shed some light into the darkness of the history of such terms. You basically need to know what you're talking about. But if you're now asking, so what about my system? My system itself that I'm working at or that I'm designing, how is it with regard to a WFI system, for example, to an IPI manufacturing system, or what role does the flow velocity of my liquid play in that game? Yeah, how does it influence the cleanability, and what are the boundary conditions then? In order to unveil that, I would like to welcome you in one of our next videos. So please send us your questions. We would be glad to talk about that with you. And again, take care, stay healthy, and see you in one of our next videos. Bye.